All right, I got 1 minute after 2 o'clock, so let's go ahead and get started. If there's one thing I'm known for my webinars, it's keeping them on time. And so we got a half hour today here. We wanted to show you guys a couple of cool products and introduce you to some things that we work with here that we have customers in the field that are using them and very effective. Today, we're going to focus on the HPR. So this is HP's hybrid flatbed printer. We're focused today specifically on election signage. It's an election year, but you know, yard signs, election signage, event signage. This machine is a great, great combination, a great fit to allow you to produce those very effectively, very easily, and really make it happen. I'm doing something today in today's webinar that I guarantee nobody has ever seen in a webinar before. That's a pretty bold statement. Have you ever seen anybody start a webinar with the machine not being tested? I have been on vacation. I don't know if you guys can tell. I've got a beautiful, lovely tan. I've been down in Cancun, Mexico since Wednesday last week or Thursday last week. Just got back and I did not do any preparation or maintenance of my machine. It is the exact same way that I left it when I left for Mexico. And I thought it'd be really cool to start today's webinar starting my printer. This is something I guarantee you've never seen in a webinar presentation before. Having hosted hundreds of webinars myself, you always do a little pre-check ahead of time, make sure it's all good. I have that much confidence in my HPR series that when I was planning this whole thing, I said, you know what I want to do is go ahead and start it from a cold stop. And so what you guys are seeing right now on my screen is my machine. When it's not being printed on, it sits in low power mode, all the fans are turned off. I'm going to go ahead and start in normal mode. And somebody start a stopwatch so you can see how long it takes for this thing to start up. The machine is going to go through initialize and then go through a check and clean process, get everything going. But the really neat thing about the HPR series, it is latex ink technology. It's a water-based ink formula that goes through a high heat curing process and bonds itself to the substrate, gives it great outdoor durability as well as scratch resistance. The beauty of HP latex, because it's a water-based ink formula, this machine is perfectly happy not printing. So the entire time I've been in Cancun, my machine hasn't had to wake up and purge ink and keep things fresh inside there like you would have to do with a solvent or a UV machine. This machine just goes to sleep, turns the motors into low power mode, goes to sleep, sits and waits. When I'm ready to print again, you know, week-long vacation or month-long vacation, which I think I might do next year, is go ahead and turn it on. It'll go through a check and clean process where it's going to, you know, quickly wipe down the print heads and then let me know I'm ready to go. I'm not worried about turning this machine on for the first time in a live studio audience and running some prints on here. So the machine's going through its process, going to fire up and go through it. So Julie, today we're talking about election signage. One of the more popular substrates that can be printed on this machine, but I'm not limited to producing yard signs or Coroplast signs with this. You want to take a minute to talk about the Coroplast? Actually, I'm sorry, take a minute first and introduce yourself.
My name is Sheila McLean. I've been with Grimco for about 20 years, and I've been working with our boards or substrates team since late last year. So this is something a little new for me, but I wanted to kind of just go through some of the ins and outs of Grimco and Coroplast. What some of you may or may not know is that all the Coroplast that we carry is Corona treated. And what that means is it has a receptive, however you want to look at it, coating on that material that allows the inks, regardless of whether they're UV, solvent, latex, whatever, to adhere correctly to that material so that you don't have any issues with it, with flaking, chipping, or anything along those lines when you're printing on it. So that's something to keep in mind with us. All of our Coroplast is Corona treated. We also have a very good stocking program as well as an excellent daily distribution program. So you call today, you will have your Coroplast tomorrow at your shop. We cover about 98% of the country with daily distribution. So that's something to keep in mind when you need Coroplast for your shop, whether it's for election signs, street signs, retail, whatever, we can deliver it to you next day.
And Julie, I'd say that's something I hear a lot from customers is, that's not our, we don't normally do election signs. We don't normally do vehicle graphics. We don't normally do this. It's having that confidence working with Grimco that, hey, you may not normally buy Coroplast in large quantities, but don't turn away those jobs because we got your back. We have plenty of it in stock. The other side of my wall over here is a 100,000 square foot warehouse, and we're ramped up with Coroplast right now. We always have a pretty good pile of Coroplast ready to go out the doors. But even if it's not one of those products you order on a regular basis, especially in large quantities, don't feel you need to turn those jobs away because it's not something you do regularly, we got your back. We know people need Coroplast. It's one of the probably most commonly used substrates in the sign and graphics world, and we got it in spades in all of our warehouses nationwide.
Yep, and in numerous sizes, 24 by 18, 24 36, 18 24, and 4 by 8 and 5 by 10s, as well as
and
some
flutes running vertical, flutes running horizontal. We got perfect square cut sheets. I mean, you talk about Coroplast in varieties. We offer it all. And Julie, if somebody wanted to find out the Coroplast we had available, where would they head over to?
They can look at our grimco.com webpage, so www.grimco.com. Or if you have some additional questions outside of what you see on our web store, you can feel free to reach out and call us directly.
Well, the machine is, I don't know if you guys can hear this behind me, the machine is going through its paces, booting up, getting itself ready and signed up in here. But it is doing something. It's going through its initialization booting process and getting ready to print. So I did say that this is something you would not see in a webinar elsewhere. I didn't say it was going to be something exciting, but this is the startup process every morning with this machine. It's turning it on, letting it come up to its printing capabilities, getting ready to print. So while the machine's doing its warm-up cycle, I wanted to take a second to kind of point out what's happening here, what the machine is going through. So the machine, just like HP's roll-to-roll printers, has an internal wiper unit. And so the printhead carriage is currently going through the decapping process. Like I said, it's a water-based ink formula that has to travel through this large curing module for that ink to set, but it's perfectly stable when it's not printing. All it needs to do is just go through a quick little wipe decapping. And so that's what the machine is going through right now, making sure that we're all ready to go. It's popping up on my screen. I guess I could share this with you guys too, so you could see what's happening. Pops up on my screen. I got dual touch screens on either side of the printer here, but it pops up on here and it alerts me to what's going on. And so I got expired pre-treat in here, and then it's saying there's a problem detected. Oh, and it popped that up. So I do this reinitialize and it'll clear those errors off of here, but it's giving me all the visibility, what's going on. Here's how much ink I have inside my machine. I can even look at my print heads and then see the health of my print heads. That is one of the beauty of HP Latex systems is user replaceable print heads. And so in addition to that, hey, zero maintenance when the machine is asleep, I always had that confidence of knowing, hey, my machine's going to print no matter what happens. Because if, say, I am having a problem, my machine sat for a month or so, and I'm having a problem with a print head, it's a quick, easy matter of pulling out that print head, dropping a new one in, machine will go through its calibrations, and I'm back in printing. So, but go ahead, if you had your stopwatch started, go ahead and cancel it now because we are ready to begin the print process. I'm going to head back over to the other side of the machine and get things loaded here. I'm going to print, like I said, we're printing Coroplast today. So a simple matter of telling it from the front panel, I'm going to go ahead and load Coroplast. It remembered what thickness or measurement I was printing last. I'm going to change this now, and I'm going to load multiple up sheets. So I'm going to leave this auto measure process checked off here, and then I'm going to go ahead and set some boards onto my machine. So like Julie was saying, we offer Coroplast in a bunch of different size, flavors, colors. I'm going to use 24 by 18s, you know, your standard yard sign Coroplast blank on here now. And I'm gonna get these loaded up in a multiple up process. I'm gonna print front and back. I have the R2000 here, which gives me 98 inch printable width here. So I'm gonna print four across on my R series. The machine comes in two different sizes. You have the R2000, which is a 98 inch wide belt, or the R1000, which is a 64 inch wide belt. The big difference is in that 4x8 workflow. You know, so in the R1, R2, if I'm printing 4x8 sheets, on the R1, I need to be able to print the 4-foot width. On the R2, I can turn that 4-foot portrait style and I can print that 8-foot width on here. So my print speed literally doubles just because the orientation of my 4x8 boards can change. But I have repositionable pins that I can just drop down here, and then that lets me do that repeatable distance. I'm going to feed that into my machine. There's a touch-off bar that's going to come down on the top of my material, so if it changes the height, it'll detect the difference of that height of that material. And then it'll draw the material in just a little bit further and then measure the width and positioning of each one of those sheets on here. So quick and easy to change over from one set to the next.
Hey, Neil, if you need the time, we have 6 minutes and 27 seconds from a week off cold start.
There we go. So the beauty of that is you can head to Cancun anytime you want, let your machine sit and know you can come back and print some yard signs when you get back. There we go. So it's going through its measurement process right now. Go ahead, Julie.
Say, Neil, while you're watching that do its thing, just so everybody knows, we also carry all the accessories that go with the Coroplast. So we carry all the coro stakes, the A-frames, the heavy duty stakes, the economy stakes, everything you need.
There you go. So this is the IPS, or the engine that drives the machine. And so it got all my sheets in here. I got four up on here, and it knows they're 24 inches wide all the way across the board. It didn't know the length. It doesn't measure the full length of the board, so I have to enter that number manually, but it figured out my thickness, my positioning, as well as my width for each sheet. So I'm going to hit apply here, and now I'm ready to go. I have my jobs already sent over here. I'm not printing directly from my RIP. The RIP software sends them to the IPS. And so I got a nice yard sign job up in here. Rick Astley. Apparently he's running for a position. His key points, he's never going to let you down. So we're going to run a couple of yard signs for his campaign today and hit save. And then I just drag these over. It's a very intuitive workflow. It's going to set my placements for me. Hey, it said, oh, I found an issue. I click view and it's saying invalid out of parameters because I don't have this button checked right here, which allows full bleed printing. I'll do a couple of these guys over here as well. Print four of these. Nice Sam Squanch, get this guy going. And I want to do these a double-sided workflow. So I'm going to go ahead and repeat. I've already got this queued up here. Bring over another set of the Rick Astley and then this one here. And let's kick up the quantities here. You can see how easy this queue is to work with as far as nesting and positioning your jobs, having different jobs listed in here. And it gives me a visual representation of what's going on with my job. So front side of design number two, backside, and then backside of number two. And you can see down below, it's giving me an estimated print time of 8 minutes. So it's a quick, easy workflow to get through here. Let's drop in a couple more. This is supposed to be a half hour webinar, so I'll just do some more printing to extend out that time a little bit. I'll drop in four more of these guys. And that kicked it up another minute. All right, without any further ado, let's start print. Again, you guys didn't see me don a hazmat suit. I didn't have to put on rubber gloves and purge a whole bunch of ink. The machine just woke itself up, quick little decapping of that print heads over the maintenance cartridge that's inside there, ready to start printing. And so the big key here, because it is HP Latex ink, all of HP's printers, we're talking the generation 300, 500 series printers, the brand new 700, 800 series printers, or the 630, it is always a combination of speed, ink density, and temperature. So Coroplast is a fairly temperature stable substrate. It has the flutes in there. It has ridges that are riding on the core. It's a PVC based product. It can take a little bit of heat, but I want to be able to run this really, really fast to get the most amount of production on here. And so I'm running these at three pass, 70% ink density. 70% ink density shrinks in my color gamut a little bit. So my reds may not come out as bright as I want them to be. But if I have a more demanding color, it's a simple matter of slowing the machine down to put a heavier ink saturation and then have that ink come out dry. So it's really easy to control the different print modes for all the different substrates that you have. And so the profile, that recipe that I'm using for printing Coroplast, I can run Coroplast at the max speed of this machine being three pass. On the R1000, it's gonna give you about 3 pass in the R1000, about 640 square feet per hour. On the R2000, that gives me about 900 square feet per hour. And so it's about 28 boards, 4x8 boards per hour on the R2, and you're at about 14 boards per hour on the R1. And that's full 4x8 boards. This machine is a hybrid flatbed, kind of like the pizza oven at Costco. And so when the boards are running through the machine, minimizing the amount of time that it's not printing is key. So I'm running 24x18s. It's going to have to stop every 18 inches, drop down the alignment bar, ask me to load a new sheet, and then position and then begin printing. On a 4x8 sheets, running that workflow, it asks you to load sheets less often. So I can hear the machine is going through its process, about to start printing here. These boards are going to draw through. It'll only make about 3 or 4 passes until it's ready for me to load the next set of sheets. So I'll keep you guys here for just a minute so you can see that cycle, that process of going through loading. You know, Chris, this might be a good time now to talk about the other device I got sitting right next to me here.
Yeah, the All Board Lifter is a product that we're actually spotlighting this month. We have an exclusive sale on it, 25% off until the end of March. If you're watching this live or you catch it anytime in February or March, we have that sale promotion going on. This is really, really cool for production level shops where labor is an issue. I know I've been with Grimco almost 15 years, and I know when I help out in the warehouse, you know, if you start flying around too fast with sheets, you're dropping them, you're scratching them, you're denting the corners. You know, they're awkward. With the board lifter, it really helps hone in on the labor aspect and gives you a convenient way to get the sheets to where they need to be without two people involved, without, you know, injury, without damaging your product. It's the most frustrating thing is I would help load trucks when I first started, and, you know, you make a mistake, you're in a hurry and you damage a sheet, it's going right in the trash. You know, you can't flatbed print when you got a corner smashed in and all out of whack, or you got to take time to cut the sheet up. So it's a great way to minimize your labor for really low cost and a really convenient thing.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
Give it a
Because you're not going to unload a pallet of material right in front of your machine. This allows me to bring it exactly where I need to have it. I can tilt this to move it around in my shop, you know, move this piece. It's big, heavy duty caster wheels with locks that then once I get it where I need it to be, I can lock that into place. And then I can raise or lower based on the table surface that I'm going on to. So if I was doing a 4x8 sheet workflow on here, I could then have that quick and easy to the right height where I'm not slinging a 4x8 sheet day in and day out. Nobody in the print world's getting any younger. And so, yeah, this device is way cheaper than workplace injury because somebody tore out a rotator cuff, you know, pulling sheets from the floor and getting them up onto a bed. This allows me to really position my work where I need it to be to get over to my machine. So I'm just now loading in the third set of four. So 12 signs total here. That alignment pin drops down, and now the machine is synchronizing before it pulls that material inside my machine to get us going onto the next set. Let's come around. I think my first set of prints should be finished here. And so that's what's happening is this machine is going through. The ink is being laid down in here, and then it's going through the curing module right up in here. And so, like I said, it's speed, ink density, temperature. So the machine has a thing called optimizer, which is going to pin those ink droplets in place. That optimizes a clear fluid that's positively charged to hold the ink droplet so that it doesn't coalesce or spread out or get grainy. So it can then travel through the curing module right in here. Once the prints are done, they're completely bone dry, scratch resistant, ready to go. And like I said, guys, I did zero maintenance on this. This is at 3-pass lightning fast print speed on here. But even those solid colors, reds and blues, no banding, no print artifacts whatsoever. Perfectly cold printer, ready to go, and knocking out prints one after the other.
You don't have to worry about cracking like you do with some technologies. That is a flexible ink, so that's a big advantage for latex as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And so real quick and easy, and I'm doing a double-sided workflow. So these prints went through my machine this way the first time. I'm going to use that same leading edge, so all I'm doing is turning them and then lining up that same leading edge that I ran for the first side, so I know I get that same repeatable positioning, and that print is going to come out looking the exact same way on the other way. On my IPS, it's letting me know exactly what board it's currently printing, as well as what board it wants to print next. I can continue to add. Let's run this guy back over here. I can continue to add onto my queue. Say I job comes through at the last second. I need four more of those Rick Ashley photos, and I can keep adding to my queue as it's going. So like I said, this is like the pizza oven at the Costco. You just keep feeding boards into it, and sausage, pepperoni. I wish they would bring back the combo pizza. If anybody from Costco's listeners catches this video, it's just keep that belt moving, keep the boards running into it, one right after the other. Chris, like you were saying about the scratch resistant, the Coroplast and latex being impervious. Obviously scratch resistant, I can run my fingernails up here and sit, but one of the key benefits too is you need to post-process it, so you need to cut it. And I can slice into this all day long using one of our coral claw tools here, slice into it, and I never have to worry about getting chipped ink on the edges of this whatsoever. I can bend, fold, twist, whatever I need to do with this Coroplast sign over and over again in that same repeatable position, and I'm not getting ink chipping or cracking off of this at all. Let's see, how bad can I mangle this Coroplast sign to really show the flexibility of latex ink? You know, as opposed to a UV print, I'm not sure I would fold it up that way and expect not to have flakes of UV ink on my floor. Give me a nice, easy print on there, not having to worry about cracking ink.
Another thing is, if you guys see the chat, I'm dropping in favorites links that are pre-built. So, you know, for customers that want to save time, avoid ordering the wrong parts, one of the things that's nice is we have some pre-populated favorites charts, or you can create your own on our website. So, for example, whether it's Coroplast, Corostakes, or inks and printheads for your printer, our website allows you, once you have a sign-in, to create quick favorites. You can create as many as you want to, so there's no disconnect between your purchasing folks and the folks that are operating your machine. So I went ahead and dropped those in the chat.
Yeah, perfect. Thanks, Chris. And so I have, for the machine itself, I have three My Favorites list created. The R1 and the R2000, they share the consumables. So the print heads as well as the wiper unit, it's the exact same for both of those machines. The big difference between the R1 and the R2000 are the ink bags that it comes with. So the R1 uses 3-liter containers of ink, whereas the R2 has 5 liters of ink on board. And so those My Favorites lists are different. And so obviously a 5-liter ink, your cost per milliliter is going to be a little less expensive on the R2 than it is on the R1. But those Favorites lists are a good way of keeping it, you know, what stuff do I need to order for my machine? The regular consumables, keeping it nice and straight and making it easy for you to get back in business and get the right parts ordered. All right, so it's wrapping up. I think I got the last set of signs going through the machine right now. I got one more set. So let's get this last campaign ripping here. And then I'm going to switch over and print some of the 4x8s to show you guys how quick and easy it is to switch from a 24x18 over to a 4x8 workflow. You know, because that's the reality of the situation is you're switching your jobs up from time to time. You're printing different rolled medias. You're printing board sizes in different configurations. Real quick and easy to do that with the R series. This up here. For those of you who like this presentation and would be interested in seeing the full 4x8 workflow, we did a webinar on the R series. I feel like it was around St. Patrick's Day of last year, where I printed a lot of St. Patrick's Day themed yard signs, but I did a full 4x8 workflow there. You know, it was an hour long webinar then, because my objective was to print 100 yard signs double-sided. So I was doing 4x8 workflow, printing, you know, A side, B side of 10 different sheets. You get 10 24x18s on a 4x8 sheet, but I was doing a print and cut, running them on this machine and then cutting them on my Kongsberg using the corner and edge recognition of that machine. And it was able to print 100 yard signs double-sided just by myself, feeding the sheets through, printing both sides, and then bring them over to Kongsberg, slice and dice. Had a nice stack of 100 St. Patrick's Day themed yard signs. So check that video out on Grimco's YouTube channel. It's kind of cool to see how what one person and two really nice machines can get your productivity through the roof. I have done yard signs doing the old peel and stick, you know, where I'm mounting self-adhesive vinyl to a Coroplast sign and then hand cutting them apart. And it was a lot harder to do 100 yard signs that way than it is with these two machines.
Yeah, plus your costs, obviously, you're not doing vinyl, you're not having any errors in the process, you're not involving
the paint. Yeah.
So, you know, a lot of ways to save. Plus the ink is cheaper.
Right.
So the return on investment is pretty solid. The other thing, too, I should mention, we're going to have a lot of this equipment you're seeing here now at the ISA show coming up. If you go to grimco.com, we have free passes there right now. It'll be the first thing you see when you go online. Also, if you'd like to see a personalized webinar, we do those all the time. So we don't like to let Neil sit and rest and relax. He's back from vacation. He's ready to go. So
try to keep me busy. Yep.
Coming back from Cancun. So he's ready to rock. So if we want to do a live webinar just like this, but we'll print your files, we'll talk to you live. And then we always have the demo center open in person in Chicago as well. So if you are interested in more information, just email hssales@grimco.com. We can set that up for you pretty easily.
Yeah, absolutely. And so you guys can see, I mean, even printed double-sided, because I'm using that nice Corona-treated Coroplast, it gets great ink adhesion to it. But the R series, there's no hand feel to latex ink. It is the same as their HP has used with their latex roll-to-roll machines for so many years. No hand feel to this ink. I can't tell where it was printed and not printed. No smell as well. We need to invent smell-o-vision for webinars. This machine running, you know, was it when it woke itself up and began printing, it's a water-based ink form. There's no odor, there's no smells. It has GreenGuard Gold as well as Eco logo certifications. I can work around this machine all day long and I'm not gonna go home with my shirt smelling like fumes from a UV or fume from a solvent machine. Latex print can be in those sensitive situations, you know, hospitals, schools, things where you're worried about the air quality inside there. Perfectly suited for that sorts of applications. So it's water-based ink formula that dries through that high heat curing process while it's going through that printing. Really great ink set to be able to experience when you're in a somewhat closed-in environment and not having to stand around those fumes and that smell all day long. So the machine's finishing up. I'm gonna go ahead and raise up my repositioning pins here and switch over to running a 4x8 workflow. The machine's going through its cool down process. All those prints are finished. All I have to do is come over here and hit load. And I'm going to leave it sitting on that auto measure process again. Hit load on here. It's going to ask me to put this full 4x8 sheet in here. Obviously, I don't have to lean over or risk, you know, damaging my shoulder here because it's nice and easy to go with this all aboard lifter and move my sheet from one device to the other. It's going to drop down on the alignment pin. The light comes on and go ahead and load her on in. Chris, I don't know how often it has shown up in the webinar too, but I have this status symbol here. It kind of lets me know what is going on with my printer at any given point in time. And so green lets me know, hey, the machine's doing its thing. When I was between sets of boards, it flashed to yellow. So if I was somewhere else in my shop and I'm running a pallet's worth of material on here, I can quickly, easily, oh, light's yellow. I got to get over there and throw another sheet in there and keep that whole system going. Really makes it easy. Obviously, if there's a problem, it flashes on a red. It's not one you see that often or you really want to see that often. But it lets the operator keep themselves busy doing other things while the machine's printing and just keep feeding it through there. Again, like Chris had said about with yard signs, obviously, yeah, material is expensive, but the most expensive part that goes into producing a yard sign is your labor. And this allows you to really kind of maximize your labor, maximum output, you know, really being the most cost-effective way of producing a yard sign. It's direct printing. And so here, it listed in here. I just need to tell it we're printing on a 48-inch wide sheet, and we are good to go. Again, I got my job already set in a queue here. Just bring it on over here. And hit save. Here we are, 48-inch wide. Hit OK from there. And hit done. And now we're ready to print. 5 minutes to print this 4x8 sheet. Again, that's to print one 4x8 sheet is going to take 5 minutes. Not horrible. But you know, if you want, the more you add to that, the warm up and the cool down phase are taken off of that equation. Say I had to print, you know, 10 or 15 or 20 of those sheets, that warm up and cool down remains at temperature. And so the boards just keep getting fed through that machine.
Yeah. And with the hybrid printer too, Neil, people that print long unattended runs, I've gotten really good feedback from customers that, you know, if you're going beyond Coroplast, you're going to rolled goods, the accuracy is amazing.
Yeah, HP uses a system called an OBOS, Optical Belt Advanced System. Again, it was a takeaway from the roll-to-roll printers where they use an OMOS. It's basically taking a picture of the material. OMOS is Optical Media Advanced Sensor. Taking a picture of the underside of the material as it goes through the machine. On the R series, they use an OBOS because I'm printing to a belt. It's taking a picture of that belt as it's advancing the material through here. But I pulled back my table, and that is what allows me to go roll to roll. So if I have a campaign where I need to print, you know, a bunch of banners for the Sasquatch and Vote for Rick campaign, as soon as I'm done printing my rigid board, I can have my banner ready to go. And it's a simple, easy matter of switching from direct printing to substrates or direct printing to boards to direct printing with to rolled media as well. Just pull the table out of the way, throw your roll on there, and you're off to go. And that's the true beauty of a hybrid flatbed is, you know, the use that same ink technology for rolled medias as you do for rigid materials. So quick and easy to convert and be able to have a one size fits all machine that can print on either substrate.
Hey Neil, we're right up at 30 minutes. So just want to give you a heads up.
Yeah, no, I knew we were getting there and I just checked. Sure enough, we were right there. So Chris, like you had said earlier today, if you guys want to hear more about this machine, you want to come see it here live in my demo center, happy to have you in here, whether we do a virtual or an in-person machine, but this is definitely one that's nice to see up close and personal. Send an email to hssales@grimco.com. Chris, like you had said, we are going to be out at the ISA trade show. What are the dates on that one? 10th, 11th, 12th?
Yep.
In beautiful, sunny Orlando, Florida.
Yes.
I can't wait. Yeah. So I'll be there. We'll have the HPR series. We're going to have the all aboard lifter, and we're also going to have a Kongsberg cutting table in our booth. And so we'll be doing all kinds of print and cut on rigid material there. Love to see you guys there. If you need passes, again, grimco.com, we have that up there where we can get you show passes, get you all set up to come on in on the show. Julie, Chris, you guys got anything else?
You know, if anybody needs any more information on all the board or substrate stock that we carry, you can also reach out to us at boards@grimco.com. If you need a custom quote, you need something specific size-wise, we do custom quotes all day long. So feel free to reach out to us there. And if you just want to place a normal order, feel free to reach us at grimco.com or reach out to your local sales rep.
Well, Julie and Chris, thank you so much for joining me. And I want to thank all of you for attending this webinar as well. Your time is valuable, and hopefully brought some value to you and made you whet your appetite on a couple new machines here. Again, hssales@grimco.com if you have any further questions. So thanks for joining us today.